When we classify a compound as insoluble, it means that that compound usually is a solid or precipitate. Okay, and we call these guys non-electrolytes. These guys do not conduct electricity because they do not break up into ions when they are in water. So a good example here, we have what's called methanol, CH3OH. Here it's a liquid before I throw it into water. When I throw it into water, it becomes aqueous. All that aqueous means is that water is surrounding it. That's all aqueous means, water surrounds it. And what you should realize is that the compound was methanol in the beginning, it stayed intact before I threw it in. Even when it's in the water, it's still intact. It doesn't break up at all. It stays together. This is what a non-electrolyte does. It doesn't break up at all. Barium sulfate is a solid. And remember, sulfates are soluble unless they're connected to certain ions. One of those ions is barium. So that means that this compound would be insoluble following our solubility rules. So when we throw it into water, we shouldn't expect it to break up. It stays together. Now, it becomes aqueous as well because even though it's still a solid, it's surrounded by water. Because it's surrounded by water, we say its state is now aqueous. So now, this page really is, again, learning a few trends here and there. But for the most part, the bulk of it is just memorizing what you see for the solubility rules.